Hi, I am Anupriya. In this session, I'm going to discuss with you about an ice-breaking question of an interview, that is, tell me something about yourself. Alright? The time you enter in the cabin of your interviewer and ask him for the permission to take a seat and you sit there and you just handle your resume to him, he just look over at your resume, suddenly a voice comes from, tell me something about yourself. So you have all the butterflies in your stomach, you just get stressed and you are not able to answer properly. Why it is happening? I'm here to help you out, alright? So we are going to discuss this question, that how can we answer it in a simple manner without taking stress or tension. So what I have done, I have divided this answer in orders or in few segments. We will have a look that what is the right order of replying this, and that too in a simple and easy manner. Alright? If you are being asked, tell me something about yourself by your interviewer, so first thing you have to mention is your name. The format of replying this, you can say, I am Anupriya, or I can say, my name is Anupriya. Starting from both of them phrases is correct. Next comes place, where you live. So you can reply this one by saying, I am from Delhi, or I belong to Delhi. Both are right, but if you say I belong to Delhi, it seems more frequent. I am biased about it. I like it much. Third comes about your qualification, about your highest qualification. It means that if you are done with your post graduation, so inform about that. So informing about your highest qualification, the phrase should be, I am graduating, if you are a graduate, or I am post-graduating, whatever your highest qualification is, or my highest qualification is, alright, or I have recently done, if you are a fresher, you have done recently, post-graduation or graduation or any kind of qualification, so three phrases are there, I am graduating or I am post-graduating, my highest qualification is, or I have recently done. Apart from your academic qualification, if you have done anything regarding to your profession, alright, if you have done any diploma course for getting a good job, so do mention that also along with your highest qualification. So these are three phrases that you can use. These are very simple and very quick on your tongue. Coming to the fourth part, your skills and experience. If you are not a fresher and you are just running in mid of your career, so you must be carrying an experience in your life, alright, and definitely along with the experience you must be carrying few skills that you have mentioned on your resume. So if there are 4 or 5, don't recite it, speak about only 1 or 2 that you are very much strong with. Like the phrases can be, I am quite good in computers, or I am quite good in Java programming, whatever the skills it can be you are carrying. So when you say I am quite good in, it means that your opinion is it that you are probably good, you are not sure about it. It is the job of the interviewer who is going to decide whether you are good or not. So I am quite good in whatever your skills can be, alright, and I am carrying an experience of 3 year, 4 year, or 5 year, whatever it can be. You can put your experience first and skills later, both are correct. So you have to describe your experience. I have experience of 5 years, that is okay. But if you speak this phrase, I am carrying an experience of 4 year or 5 years, it seems more beautiful. Alright. Next comes speaking about your family. Lot of people don't mention it, but it is necessary. If you don't mention it in your introduction, so it is asked separately. So once you are informing about yourself in your introduction in the interview, mention this point also. Coming to the family background, the phrase should be, so far my family background is concerned. Alright, then you can discuss about your family members. We are 4 members, my parents, and about your siblings, and go on. So far my family background is concerned.
Another phrase you can say, if I talk about my family. Second phrase, or very simple one, in my family. There are 4 members, 5 members, whatever. So these phrases are very easy and quick on your tongue when you inform about your family to the interviewer. Last one is about describing your hobbies. You have to maintain a very light tone once you speak about the hobbies, because it is a personal note which is not very much affiliated with your professionalism. Alright, you are describing your personal information in this segment. So the phrase can be, the phrase should be, I have couple of hobbies. First phrase. Next phrase it could be, if I mention about my hobbies or if I talk about my hobbies. I am fond of reading books, or I am fond of watching movies, whatever it can be. Or I love. 2 phrases are there. So when you say I am fond of, it is actually very beautiful. Alright. And end of the introduction, when the introduction is done, you can say, that's all about me, sir. Now, most important thing, I have noticed in lots of sessions, once you introduce yourself in an interview, what do you do? Sir, my name is Anupriya. Sir, I live in Delhi. Sir, my highest qualification is this. Sir, I am carrying. So using this regard, sir or ma'am, again and again, after each segment, seems very awkward as well as annoying. Yes. Avoid mentioning this regard, sir or ma'am, again and again during the whole answer. Once you have started replying, then you can say, sir, my name is XYZ, and go on. And when the introduction is done, then you can say, that's all about me, sir. Only 2 times, or more than that, you can mention 3 times, that too with a long gap. Otherwise, it seems very awkward. And one more thing. Once you are asked, tell me something about yourself. Alright, so you will start with your name. When only the question is, tell me something about yourself. I am Anupriya. But if the interviewer asks me, he is looking over my resume and he says, alright Anupriya, tell me something about yourself. So I will not mention my name. I'll start with, sir, I belong to this, because he has already addressed my name. This seems very unnatural and artificial when you reply your name immediate after he speaks your name. So do keep it in your mind, once he's pronouncing your name, you need not to mention your name again in the introduction. You can directly start from the place or anything else. So how you interview, how your introduction appears in an interview, that is, sir, my name is Anupriya, I belong to Delhi, my recent qualification is I am postgraduate in arts stream, I am carrying experience of 5 years, I am very good in delivering classroom lectures. So far my family background is concerned, there are 4 members in my family, my parents, we are 2 siblings, I am the youngest one. And if I talk about my hobbies, I'm fond of listening light music, playing badminton, exploring the different kind of places. That's all about me, sir. This was a very sweet and short interview that you have provided all the information in a proper order. So once you go for a kind of interview, do prepare this answer well, because when the beginning is clean, when the beginning is confident, definitely you maintain a relationship with the interviewer in a proper manner, and rest of the interview is going to rock and you will definitely crack it. So best of luck. Bye.